mean.
Yes, yeah, that's true, but just because
don't trust him.
I mean, just because he's a little different doesn't mean
the bad guy.
I mean, just because he looks strange and acts strange, smells strange, talks strange, doesn't mean he's a bad guy. It just means he's different. I think if you give him a chance, I think you'll find out he's a pretty smart guy.
I think so.
So let me ask you this. Will you just give him a chance?
Thank you.
kids lead the offering. So the kids have brought money all week long, and they've had an offering every single night, and it's gone back and forth. The girls want some, the boys want some. But now it's the last one. Now they're asking you to help them out. So over here, this is the boys' bucket. If you want to help out the boys, this is that one. It's one right there. Thank you. verses 3, 13, and 18. I'll read out loud with excitement. Only by pride, oh my gosh, it's just a mouthful. Only by pride, please understand that first word. When God considered the word only, he knew exactly what he was talking about. Like when he says, all, for all that have saved, he knew he was talking about. When he said, everyone that saved all will go to heaven, he knew he was talking about. So God chooses words and understands the full volume and weight of that word. We don't, he does. So here, only by pride cometh contention. But with the well advised is wisdom. Verse 18, please. Instruction, but he that regardeth reproof shall be honored. I'm going to put these two verses to my ear as far as I can here. Let's pray. Father, thank you for the word, your word. You are the word. John chapter 1, verse number 1. In the beginning, the word was with God, and the word was God. And then in verse 14, and the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. So we understand you are. Word is you. You and the Father are one, and we are supposed to be one with you, like you are with Father. And so we understand all this. So now we read the Proverbs and try to understand more properly. You don't think you know things. And then may we not fuss with you like we're talking to another man, but we would understand this is God talking to us. This is God talking to us. This is God trying to inform us and help us on His level. Or to understand more perfectly His ways. So I pray and tell Lord, I'll help your people to know. Thank you for the word of God in Jesus' name. You may be seated. When I read a proverb according to chapter number 1, you're supposed to get something out of it. Now, you'll not always get what I get out of it because it's like a first grader reading calculus. Maybe they got something out of it. And if they did, you say, well, something out of it. You're a 12th grader, ought to get more than that. Right? Okay, same thing with spiritual things. All you 12th graders have one thing out of it. You ought to get more out of it the longer you're in this thing. Would that make sense to you? Okay, so what I would get out of this in verse number 10 of chapter 13, less pride, less fight. You know what contention is? It's an old word to contend. Means to put up a fight. And so when it says, here in verse number 10, in chapter 13, it says, only by pride cometh fighting. Just think about all the verbal fights that you have and all of the contentions and contentious attitudes you run into. God says, one reason for that. Now, I know what you're thinking right now. If I agree with that, you see, I'm just trying to prove a point. That's what we do. Okay, so I want to help you with your argument, and then I want to test it. Okay, I like to play dumb to find out who the smart ones are. Some of you really told me at one time. There was a guy I used to know, his dad, he was still tobacco. Okay, and the whole time he had his dad tobacco around in here, he'd go all along, he'd wipe his mouth when he's asleep, and you think he's the dumbest person in the world. Maybe he's sitting here. And he'd always win the bid in the battle. And when you walk away, you went, what did you think? He was playing dumb. He wasn't to find out how smart you were. And if you weren't, he got it wrong. So, less pride, less fight. Example, one man bumps into another. You ever know that happens? Okay. One man bumps into another and says, hey, watch where you're going. Right at this point, the other guy has an option. At that point, he has an option. Everybody does. But we say we have no choice. Everybody has a choice. It just determines whether you think it's worth to pay the price. Okay, so here's the other thing. He can play it down, let it go, make an excuse, and say, simply, misunderstanding. I'm sorry. We can say that. That's a choice, right? Or me. You bumped into me, right? This is what happened. Okay, road rage. right many times is nothing more than pride. Surely not has anything. We argue it like it has to do with right or wrong. A lot of times it's just pride. So patient, you're not big on your own definitions of words. Do you really know what pride? Now, normally when you ask somebody, do you know the definition of something? They end up giving you an illustration instead of the definition. Do you follow me? Okay. So I'm going to give you a definition. Okay. Here it is. Pride means this: an inordinate self-esteem, an unreasonable conceit of one's own superiority in talents, beauty, wealth, and many other gifts, which manifests itself in a lofty air. Amazing how we use what God gave us against other people. Okay? What's he saying? I don't know what can thou, O man, I'm going to pause thy stature to 1 cubit, which is 18 inches. Can you make yourself today grow 18 inches? What are you taking all the credit for yourself? That's the least God said that you could possibly do. You can't even do that. So, I'm just telling you what God said. So, it's an inordinate. Everybody has some of these limits, but it's an inordinate. You just, there's an air about us that's like, you have no right to talk to me that way. First of all, let's just bring it down, okay? Who do you think you are? Well, I'm trying to be smart. Who do I think I are? I am the preacher. When I work for Rockwell, he's got engineering teaching. I'm an engineer. But please understand, it's an inordinate thinking or feeling about oneself in any area. Beauty, I have to talent, superiority, understanding. Information, whatever the case is, we love to do that. One person will never give way, let go of a matter, and they continue to press the matter to prove their point. How many people do that? Even when we're told we're wrong, we try to define why or what we were trying to do. I got an idea. How about this? I guess you're wrong. That kills us. Absolutely kills us to say, well, no, if you look at it this way, I wasn't, because I didn't know this, and I was trying to do that, and didn't you understand? Why don't you just do this? Right? That's what we do. So in verse number 10, God says, only by pride cometh contention. Contention means to chase. You have to let go. They're even trying to get away. You have road rage. One person's trying to get away from another idiot, right? And the idiot just keeps following, trying to prove a point that you understand what kind of problems you're going to be yourself into. You pull that gun, run that gun off the road, that lady, whatever the case may be, do you understand how silly it's like you're flying down the freeway and a policeman pulls you over and they always ask you the most obvious questions, do they not? What's the problem? Do you know you were speeding? They already know the answer to that, don't they? It's like why it's like your mom when you were living. You broke a lamp, she saw you do it, and she asked this question. Did you do that? You want me to stand right there? Or she asked another thing. Why did you do that? I first gave you a break. We ask these kinds of questions, and what they say, what if they don't ever tell them you're in a hurry. Oh, they love that. Really? How much farther down the road would you be if I could not pull you over? They love to say that stuff. Because they know they're running, because everything you were doing, saying it's not again, I was wrong. You want to get out of the ticket if you can. I've never seen a man do that. I happen to know a young man that does all the time. But just tell them, no, I'm just kidding. They just want to know if you're going to continue. You're wrong, I'm right, so you don't fuss about this. And so what it is, it simply means to chase, it means to pursue, it means to follow after, it means to fight with. Pride means you cross this line, we're fighting. Christian, well, Christian, I still got Christians in this church, right? So what happens? They have a choice. You can either go along with the authorities and their judgment. You can humble yourself down and simply say, I didn't notice it. And I'll take care of it. That's what I mean. Right? And you're trying to figure out which option you're doing. That's it. When you say, like, yes, you should judge, you're going to get judgment right now. So let's just talk. Or number two, well, I see nothing wrong with it myself. It's a good reason. You show me. Your arrogance, you're assuming you're never wrong. But when you simply say that, well, he's not bad. Well, the next one, you said the same thing. And the next one, you said the same thing. So basically, you're never. Brother Gray said one time about fundamental Baptist preachers. He said, you know what's wrong with fundamental Baptist preachers? We're so right most of the time, we think we're right all the time. That's a true statement. Presumptuousness is causing you to chase a matter, to pursue it until you're going to fight with it. Now, here's where we get real righteous, like it's right. You little girls come in here dressed up like a friend of your party. Setting before the principal, right? Or before the preacher. And now you're stuck. That's what you're saying. What do you want me to tell her when I get home? How about humbling yourself and simply say, you need to talk to her. And the principal is right. And your mom and you are going to take us back. You're so afraid. What do you expect me to do? Just act like it didn't happen? No, I expect you to handle the problem. No, I don't expect you not to handle the problem. That's one of the worst things you can do. I want you to handle the problem, but let's use a little Christianity. Well, let's use the wrong word. I didn't do it. Let my daughter just think I won't stick up for her. Oh, that's worse than missing heaven. We go home and go like, we look at it. What am I saying? I don't know. What are you going to say when they kind of take something from the car? They got something. They got a point. It's not your fault. You've got to figure out how to handle the problem. You can't just let it go. Look at verse number 13, the last part. But now we're going to change. Remember, that's our pivotal word in most of the Proverbs. You will see it's like an antithesis. It's the opposite. You'll read in most Proverbs, you'll read a statement, subtle word saying, okay, we're getting ready to change to the opposite in Israel 6. But with the well advised is wisdom. Well advised, that is a word that we talk a lot about, really don't understand what we did. Well advised means consulted. Advised means, you ready for this? You ready for this one? It means guided. But you see, we already know everything. Now what it's saying. But that's what we're doing is advised. We don't ask for counsel, which is one of those words for being well advised. You know what? We already know what to do. I can tell by our world, we all know what to do. First, what is next? It wasn't God that made the mess. It was us that made the mess by not following God. So here he says, but with the well advised is wisdom. Well advised means consulted, guided, counseled. Is wisdom in getting the right advice, being counseled right, being led in thought in the right way, the Bible says is, ready for this, wisdom. Wisdom is the greatest thing you can obtain. And all I get, you get wisdom. Wisdom is the principal thing. That's what Bible says. Okay? Throughout the Bible, especially in the book of Proverbs, you'll see over and over again, knowledge, that's our instruction, knowledge, understanding, wisdom, and you make a word. So if you're not good at it, first of all, even follow the instructions, get the new wisdom, or it's not going to do it. Trouble is, we think we know all kinds of wisdom, we don't even follow the instructions. I'm just telling you about the word. So what we find out here is, let me advise you on how to handle pride, okay? Just in case somebody down the church down the street has pride, maybe go teach them. This is not good thing about this. Okay? Ready? Number one. Okay, number one. Always play the problem down to reality. We have a tendency to play, what? Honey, get my gun. Where are the put numbers? Stop it, please. Play it down. By the time it's done, you go, oh, is that all that happened? Fellas, can I help you? Since the ladies are listening in, I don't know about the guys today. Back in the day, guys would go like, yeah, I'm not willing. I promise you, I'm not making this up. Ladies, look at it. Man, one had two, whatever. In my office, when I was in the farmhouse over here, a professional woman, a nurse that worked in the emergency room. Her husband said, okay, I'll get rid of him. The bench is not bad. He finally got rid of him. And the whole time he just sat there like, yeah. She got so frustrated. Now, understand, I'm in the emergency room. I'm having problems. And this woman's in here. She sat in my office and begins to dip her feet in the floor. Grabs her own hair. She grabbed her own hair and pulls her hair out like this and is screaming. And I said, shut up, sit down. I said, you work in the emergency room, you're a nurse. You do that here. Oh, no, they won't let me. So personally, I blame him, but whatever. You have to understand here, you need to always play the problem down. Play it down like it doesn't matter. Play it down to its reality. Don't let your kids play up a problem on you. We'll talk about that in a minute. Number two, always side with authority. Well, I know a child that, I know a woman that, we always want to run people up. Children's services, they want to show you the burden victims and the good thing. It's just like the news today. Every black person hates, I was talking to Socks one day, Socks right there. This whole Asian being picked on stuff. I always like to know something. Hey, no, you can't be. That's not so funny. It's all made up. I don't know what you say. She's Asian. I knew you wouldn't catch on to that. I don't wonder what was different. Yeah, Mama's just going to point that out to you, too. You didn't know that either. Okay, so what's the difference? The training, the teaching. The people in the world right now do not want people to get along. They are playing us against each other. Can you come to a place here? And it's like, you can't say, a little white girl's the new one. She was a white girl, I'm putting it out here. said, you want to know something? Okay, so where do you think that comes from? Mother's womb. Until she came here, it worked until she came here. That's just being forced on you till you come here. And I looked like, oh, I'm not going to turn out like that. The Lord did. Put it out there, okay? Always side with authority. Look. We understand. God's word is true. God is never wrong. Never wrong. I'm here with society, guys. God is never wrong. If God is never wrong, then he cannot be God, because God is perfect. In order to be perfect, God's always going to be right. Right? Okay. Number three. Never believe what a child says exactly. Look, number four. What do you think their precept of situations really are? Them stealing is when somebody takes the case and found a bag and said you ran from it. You know what I mean? They stole. You think she stole? Like, she stressed it. She wouldn't steal. That's not what you mean. Let me give you an example. Did they tell you anything? First of all, she never did tell you anything. I even tell married couples. That's why I do not counsel with one or the other. Okay, so it's different. Because if I counsel with one, I'm getting to one side. I would lie to you. No, you're the way you saw it, the way you received it, the way you feel about it. I didn't mean you're purposely lying, but that's what we tend to do. How often have I brought a husband and wife and said, yeah, and the wife would look at home and go, when did you say, I don't remember your son? They'll go, oh, that could change the whole thing. So she wasn't lying. He wasn't lying. It was their perception of what took place with that. Did they add emphasis? That's emphasis. Standing before your dad, he knocked me down, they beat me up, they made fun of me, then they spit on me. That's emphasis, right? But actually, all they did was knock me down. But throughout the week, they did the rest of it and put it all together. How much was assumption on that part? What else could it be? We even adults don't get that. Well, it happened to us. I mean, seriously, what else could it be? It sounds like newscasters, right? But at this time, we had no information, don't know who's involved or what's going on. What else could it be? We went, yeah, you've got a malady. So, number four, if child and wife or friend has been wrong, use it as an opportunity to teach what happened before. We even made a little good. We don't want to teach our children, our wife, our husband, or anybody else, to the line preachers right now, how to handle an absolute injustice. We don't want to do that. We're trying to teach like a lot of the C generation and the X generation and the other X generation. So I look at all this, and everybody's got their own labels, and nobody's doing it right. We don't know how to handle us, and we're trying to handle the world. Do you know who's in authority right now? Hippies. Hippies and skippies. This would be funny if I wasn't making this stuff up. And so what happens, right, by the way? So here's what you have to understand. Use it as an opportunity. How to act to an injustice. I've talked to people who've been prisons all their life that still don't know how to train their kids. They're going, yeah, the prison's not in prison. No, you missed the point, because it was done on purpose. I know it was. Somebody asked me the other day, I just want to say, I'm going to tell you, how to forgive or what you thought. And you can write all you want to make it make sense. What, you want me to lie? Yeah, I'm a pastor. I want you to lie. But what did you do with your sin? I'm not asking you
it as an opportunity how to overlook and make excuse for others' actions. It's not only, you can't go through the world, everybody acting like you don't your family. I'm just telling you, this is coming from our kingdom. So as of right now, I will be retiring in 10 years. I can't really give you the reason. So, some folks think so, number five, if you must follow through, we need to have a talk. Oh, that's a good approach. That'll work right there. And all the preacher, all the time, I wanted to talk. I said, we need to talk. I told the truth. It was your approach. It was your attitude. I didn't mean anything by it. But I came across that way. Okay? But you do that too. Chapter 13, verse 18. But poverty and shame shall be to him that refuseth instruction. It's not that it wasn't given. It was given. You don't want it. Okay? You have to refuse it. It has to be given before you can refuse it. And what happens here is simply the rest of the verse. But there's our pivotal word again. Here is the antithesis. Here is the opposite of what we just read. He that regardeth reproof. Now that is stronger language than instruction. So be honest. Obeying warns. I'm sorry. Obeying, not just listening. Warnings brings advancements. You can get ahead by being warned. I told you something there before we get this. And boot camp, I never could figure out boot camp that I teach in school. I never understood it. You're doing nothing. That's the point. You're doing nothing. You got fired. I like the one who goes, I was fired from being a Christian. Are you kidding me? You don't go to school when you do pass out a tract. You don't come to church and tell me they fired you from being a Christian. Somebody's lying here. So, we, you don't listen. And if you don't listen, you're not going to get paid. You're not going to advance. Let me prove my point. How many Christians could be farther down the road, have more influence, be promoted more on another level by God and man, receive more honor than they have been receiving if they would have obeyed a warning given by God and others? introduce correction or criticism by those who cared enough and knew better than others. I think, yeah, I can figure it out. Okay. And you wonder why that guy this, and say to yourself, look, he's judging everybody. At that same time, you're judging me for what I just said, but it's okay for you, not for me. What I'm using truth and you're using personal opinion. How many moms and dads will never be used in a greater capacity because of their children? Instruction. If you will not receive instruction, put that through over there. That's instruction. I tell you why. Why is knowledge of sin? That comes later. If you're not going to do that, you never will. We're looking for wisdom, so we sit around and stroke our two whiskers and tell everybody, well, let me tell you what I learned when I went to college right here. It's such ignorant statements that we make, and we fall for them without even thinking of what is right and wrong anymore. So the Bible has a lot of wisdom that can help you get through all this foolishness and this darkness and this blindness. Please, shut off CNN. A few years ago, we all said that anyway, but anyway, just stop it. You know what? It's all one story. Don't even want to bring up the other side. And we've got people to this day who are not going back to church and know that they didn't want to see them. You know what? Because they're going to die if they step out of the house. We've been stepping out of the house for over a year. I'm not doing it. exponentially moving forward. And then you have clarity and yes, they have. I'm also coming from the desk. So what's happening? You got this. Wasn't it just 2 years ago they were?
Yeah.
But see, now they have computers. The computers, that do computers. And it's jumping forward so quick. And here we are. See how foolish we are. You can't keep up with the information you've got on your phone. Did you want the next faster because you need more gigs? I used to think that was somebody playing a band looking for a place to play. That just came to me. Why I could forget some things and stuff like that. I wish I could forget, but I don't understand. But anyway, folks, listen to me. He is called the God of wisdom. That's the one. Generation, same devil, same heaven, same hell, same. Everything is the same, but he's got new people to work on. So preachers have decided to quit preaching the same book and start making